Hello and good morning. First commentary video in the year 2011. Erica is behaving like an Indian. She wants to be in the shot as well. We just left Kucharau and we are heading southwest now. We figured instead of riding back to Chhatarpur, we're gonna be all clever and take an alternative route, and this should be a shortcut.
We are still on that small little road to Bijawad, and Adrian has snapped the cable on his surly handlebar bag.
We did 6 kilometers on this road. Let's hope this is not a bad omen. And this has been on there so long that... There you go. Something new on my bike for once. So we're still on our alternate route to Sattar, and those alternate routes seem to be a bit jinxed. We did 6 kilometers before my handlebar mount snapped and we had to stop and replace it.
But it actually, I think it was kind of worth it, because you stopped and got a game in of whatever it is, that stick game that they play.
Get the thing in the air and then hit it?
I'm never gonna
hit it . So we're 43 kilometers into our shortcut ride. I would say by the latest positive estimates, we're probably going to have 10 kilometers that we saved with this. The going has been tough in the last about 20 kilometers. It's a roller coaster with short steep climbs, and it's always at the bottom of those dips. The road is unpaved, most likely so that during the monsoon season the water can flow freely and doesn't destroy the road, or it would destroy the road anyway. So it has been slow, we're riding in a strong headwind, but it's certainly a different India than we've seen so far. We're still on the alternate route, and there's a 60 people battle here on which road to take right now. Hello. It's 5 o'clock on our alternate route day. We just wasted an hour trying to find the SDM collector who would have given us, maybe if you weren't too lazy, permission to stay at the rest house, but he wasn't anywhere to be found, apparently out of town, and apparently there is no representative in his place, so nobody would let us stay there. So now we're riding out of town, maybe another 10 minutes, and then we will have to have found a camping spot. So, we theoretically have found a relatively decent spot to camp. It's fenced off the road, they're just footpaths. The problem right now is to find a spot without human shit. Excuse my language. But that's what it is. This is our field.
Okay, now we're walking over to get our bicycles. And well, this is actually a lovely spot, which kind of seems like it would be secluded because there's a massively huge tree here on a mound, which is hiding us from the highway, which is over there. However, this particular area, it's full of shit. It's everywhere. That's where you step. Everywhere. And the really gross thing about it is that even while there's bullshit everywhere, right here, next to my lovely bicycle, which is laying on the ground, is human stuff. It's nasty. So we're not staying here.
Okay, I think we found our camping spot for tonight. But now the last task before the sun goes down is...
it's going down.
Find the cow shit. And get it out of the way! Now, of course, Indians would do that with bare hands. I don't. That's maybe even human shit. It's completely dry, but still, it's nasty.
It's nasty!
In commemoration of our chosen camping spot, the first one here in India, we are leaving as a monument to the cows. This massive pile of doo-doo.